from some of the band members.
This band's about to fall apart.
There wasn't gonna be a Blue October anymore. And there might not be a Justin anymore.
You just watch a clip from a documentary called Get Back Up. It's the last 7 years of the life of lead singer Blue October, Justin Furstenfeld. He shares his life because he wants you to know about his battle with addiction and mental illness and how he got to the other side of that. Let's bring into our show this morning, Justin. First of all, good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I am doing great. First of all, and most importantly, how are you?
I'm awesome. Like, I am so good. It's crazy. I feel more blessed every single day. So thank you very much for having me on this show. I'm truly honored that you would spend your time with me.
You talk about the documentary, which was shot over the course of 7 years, and it was a very raw and real look at your life. Let's start kind of back at the beginning. When did you first realize that you were struggling with mental illness that ultimately turned into addiction?
I've always known that I had depression, like severe depression, and I've always been on medication for it. It's just when I started mixing drugs and alcohol to think that it solved the problem for a temporary solution to a permanent problem. It took my wife, my mom, my dad, and the band, and some people in the music industry to really put it in my face that this was a huge problem and you're not doing well. So 8 years ago, I decided to make a change in my life, and it's the best decision I ever made, and that was to get sober, and then I could, with a clean head, attack the depression and really find out what was wrong with me. And I truly believe that that's the only way that I could be in such a peaceful place today is by getting clean sober first. So then I could look at depression and mental illness with a clean brain, you know?
Justin, what was that rock bottom moment for you where you decided I have no other option but sobriety?
My kids, I had one on the way, and my wife sitting down and saying that she was going to leave and I would never see my daughter if I didn't get clean. And that was very hard for her to say because she knew how much I loved my other child. But it was that. It was tough love is what it really was. It was my parents saying that they're no longer going to speak to me. It's the band saying the band's over. It's my management saying that we're no longer going to manage you. It's when people really told me that I'm going to be alone and they meant it. That's what was my rock bottom. That was my rock bottom. If they would have been an enabler and they would have still kept coming around, I wouldn't be clean today.
Tackling sobriety is one component, one thing that you were able to successfully work your way through. But then you still had to deal with the depression on top of that. That's something a lot of people can relate to right now, Justin. Is there any advice you could share for people who might be dealing with depression?
Oh, this is my advice straight up. Don't fuel the flame. That means alcohol, drugs, even marijuana. I know people think that it's not a drug, but for people with depression, it don't fuel the flame. Don't fuel the flame. Give yourself a good month without any toxins, without any poisons in your system. Then go walking, go exercising, get outside, get on the right medication, go see a therapist, take your medication every day, and you'll notice that your brain is at least starting to clear up. You're no longer polluting what is already there, and you can start putting your depression out in front of you and going, this is what I can solve, this is what I can't handle, this is what I can handle, and then the rest you take to a doctor, and you seriously focus on it and make it your first priority. Staying clean, don't pollute your system, live clean, live active, and surround yourself with positive people.
You've personally written over 600 songs, many of them with the Blue October. A lot of those songs, Justin, were written in the depths of your addiction and your mental illness. And what was very troubling for you was turning out to be wonderful music that was selling really fast. I know this is an odd question, but do you find it difficult to continue to write passionate music on this side of everything?
I was writing songs, and the only thing I would write my songs about, those 450 something songs that I'd written before, were about one thing: me and how hard life was. And there's only so long somebody wants to listen to someone complain about how hard their life is before they go, can't have it anymore. Do something about it. Stop being lazy. So when I got sober, guess what I found out? That I had a natural God-given craft that I could perfect, study on, learn from others, work with others, and become even better than I was before, and write about not just me, write about love, loss, pursuit of happiness, peace, confidence, the smell of rain, the ocean and how it feels, my firstborn. All of these beautiful things were out there, and they're not about me anymore, which is one of the most amazing things. I'm inspired by every single thing in this world because I'm allowed to see it these days because I stay sober and I stay positive and I just look for the miracles.
How can people check out this documentary? And I know that you're also opening yourself up to question and answer sessions with viewers.
Oh yeah, it's pretty cool. May 21st on getbackup.tv. It's a platform that we set up. I would never have been able to do this sober. We set up a platform, a streaming platform, during this time, during this pandemic, so people can go watch this on getbackup.tv on May 21st, and it's the premiere. They can watch it from their house, and then after the documentary, I'm going to pop up, with popcorn grease all over my face or something, and I'm going to answer questions from people, and it's going to be probably one of the coolest things I've ever been a part of. This director, Nori Nivens, really took this piece and didn't let me touch it so it would be raw. He didn't let me make myself look pretty. He let it speak through the eyes of recovery and spirituality and positivity. And I'm so excited about it.
Justin Furstenfeld from Blue October, thank you so much for sharing your life with the rest of us. You were truly inspiring. Thanks.
Thank you so much. God bless.